Joyner Lucas just released his 10-band single, and if you've seen the album art, it's pretty sick. It's this trippy, hand-face-grabbing weird thing, and I love it. So I made it. And you can too. I'll show you how to shoot the photography and what to do in Photoshop to create this double exposure effect. Stick around, I'll show you how to be a one-man show. Hit the subscribe button and the bell icon if you want to keep your production skills sharp. Phase 1. Photo shoot. To make this effect work, I had to take two photos. A photo of my face, and a photo of my hands over my face. You want to shoot your photos in a place with enough lighting, and if you don't have studio lights, shoot near a window to make use of the natural light. You'll also want to shoot against a flat backdrop, such as a wall or a curtain that's pulled tight. I use the timer and continuous shooting modes on my camera so I didn't have to move as I'm moving my hands from my side up to my face. The key here is to be as still as you can while you bring your hands to your face for the second photo. Unfortunately, that's a lot easier said than done. So, phase 2, post-production. In Photoshop, I opened up both photos in the same document with the face layer on top of the hands layer. I went ahead and lined up the two photos as best as possible. I then removed the background from both layers so I can add a custom backdrop later. Okay, now we're ready to create the double exposure effect. With the face layer selected, change the blending mode to darker color. The hands layer will now become visible and you can see this effect starting to take shape. At this point in the process, we'll be able to see if there's anything in our bottom hands layer that's interfering with the overall image. We see spots on the sweatshirt and around the ear that are causing some trouble, so we'll simply erase them from the hands layer. Once we've cleaned up the image, we're ready to move forward. With the face layer selected, create an exposure adjustment layer and set the following parameters. For exposure, set it to 0.58, leave the offset at 0, and adjust the gamma correction to 1.4. Next, create a second adjustment layer and select black and white. Now, adjust the settings on the exposure adjustment layer to make the details come through on the hands and face. You may notice the fingertips lose a lot of detail here, but we're going to be fixing that in a few steps. We're going to create a composite layer of all the work that we've done so far. We'll essentially flatten the image without grouping the layers. Use the keyboard shortcut Control, Shift, Alt, E to create a new composite layer. Name this layer Composite and position it on top of the other layers. Now, turn off the visibility of the composite and original face layers. Select the hands layer and hit Ctrl plus J to make a copy. Change the blending mode to darker color and create another composite with Ctrl, Shift, Alt, E. Name this layer Composite Hands and move it to the top of the pile. Next, we'll create an inverse mask on the Composite Hands layer by holding the Alt key and selecting the layer mask. We're going to use this inverse mask with the brush tool to really make this effect pop. Turn on the visibility of the composite layer. With the mask selected, set the foreground color to white and press B to select the brush tool. Adjust the hardness of the brush to 0 and make sure opacity and flow are both set to 100%. Use the bracket keys to resize the brush to the size of the fingernails and carefully brush on the inverse mask to bring back the details. This is where the magic really happens. Use a medium-sized brush to bring through finger details and use small brushes for the creases of the finger. The subtle details here are what are gonna sell the effect. And trust me, it's okay to keep the history window open and experiment with different brush sizes and opacities. While you're doing this, don't brush over the areas of the face you wanna keep, such as the eyes, the eyebrows, the mouth, and the nose. And don't forget to split the chin to really sell this effect. And that's how you do it. Now that I'm done, I'll flatten the image and maybe add some shadow highlights to make things pop even more, but that's basically it. I'll save it and set it as my profile picture for, well, all my accounts probably. Piece of cake, huh? I hope you found this tutorial helpful. If you have questions, please leave them in the comments below. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you want more tutorials like this, hit the subscribe button so I know to make more Photoshop tutorials for you. Until next time, my name is Steve. Thanks for tuning in to One Man Show.